extra crispy. I hope that's all right. And they were out of french fries, so I got onion rings.
I can't believe they even sell this stuff, man. It's so plastic.
Plastic? Oh, plastic. Yeah, it's totally plastic.
So how can you buy it?
Me? I don't. Well, unless, you know, I'm stuck at the beauty parlor and I haven't done the marketing and it's time to pick Billy up at Little League.
Charlie says the fast food is a stinking slow. Americans laugh up the way a dog returns to its own vomit. Charlie says that in America, the chickens are finally coming home to roost, rotting and reeking with the oozing pots of society devouring its own anus.
Who's Charlie?
Charlie Manson.
Charlie Manson, the mass murderer? Is he a friend of yours?
I'm his lover and his slave.
Far out. You know, it's kind of weird, but I actually knew a guy named Charlie Manson back in high school. I also knew a guy named Guy Lombardo. He was captain of the football team.
Charlie says that football is a form of slavery in which the black man is seated in strength and ruthlessly exploited by a racist ruling class. Charlie says that one day the black man would throw off his chains and laugh back at the pigs who are tormented. Charlie says that in the Armageddon which ensues, women will be raped and disemboweled. Men will be captured, lynched, and burned alive. Bloody gore will choke out streets. When two sides will wipe each other out, Charlie will emerge as king of a new order with me beside him as queen.
I love your beads.
My what?
Your beads. I must have spent an hour on Main Street trying to find a string of beads just like that, but all I could find were beads. The salesman told me that they were groovy, but I don't think they're groovy. I think yours are groovy. Actually, I think they're psychedelic. What's happening?
Groovy, psychedelic, the way you talk, you sound just like a narc.
I am a narc.
What?
I mean, I was. They fired me.
Who fired you?
The FBI.
Worked for the FBI?
Yep. Right before I was a CPA. No, right after. Who was my husband then? Was it Jack? No, Jack was when I had amnesia.
You had amnesia?
You're kidding me, I did. it's like a joke, you know. If I had amnesia, I wouldn't be able to remember anything, including that I had amnesia.
Are you making this stuff up?
I don't know. I mean, I'm not, but I don't know. Was I really in the Women's Army Corps? Did I really have five husbands? If I had four children, where are they?
I was like you once, lost, confused, piece of shit. And then I met Charlie. It was down on the beach in Venice. I just got in a big fight with my dad about, I don't know, my eye makeup from the bombing of Cambodia. He said I was stuck back in a whore and I should get out of his house forever.
I think there's a new perfume called Charlie.
I went down to the beach and I sat down in the sand and cried. I felt like I was disappearing, like the whole world was dividing into two parts, me and everybody else. And then this guy came down the beach, this dirty-looking little elf. He stopped in front of me and smiled his twinkly devil smile and said, your daddy kicked you out. He knew. Your daddy kicked you out. How could he know? My daddy didn't tell him, so who could've? God. God sent this dirty-looking little elf to save a little girl lost on a beach. He smiled again and touched my hand. And off he went. For a moment, I just watched him go. Then I ran and caught his hand, and until they arrested him for stabbing Sharon Tate, I never let it go. What's the matter?
He reminds me of my daddy.
Who does? Colonel Sanders?
No! Your daddy reminds me of my daddy. I loved him so much, and he said he loved me, and then he threw me out.
Let's kill him.
Okay. What are you doing?
Giving him the evil eye.
No, that's a picture on a box of chicken.
It's a graven image. Charlie taught us how to do it.
And you can really kill people like that? Neat. Think it's working?
I don't know.
Then let's try this.